JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 12th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued to slide against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It fell the most against CAD, AUD and CHF, while it gained some ground only versus NOK. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of the US dollar suggests that US Treasury yields continued their retreat, while equities may have kept marching north. Indeed, looking at the performance of major global stock indices, we see that the EU and US ones were a sea of green, with Nasdaq gaining the most, 2.52%. The German DAX, the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 hit fresh record highs. The positive sentiment rolled over into the Asian session today as well. The only exception was Hong Kong's Hang Seng, which slid 2%. Following the soft US inflation data on Wednesday, inflation fears continued to ease on Thursday, especially after the ECB decided to accelerate its pandemic emergency purchase program in order to stop any unwarranted rise in debt financing costs, which mostly mirrored a similar shift in US treasuries rather than reflecting improved economic prospects across the Eurozone. In any case, the Euro did not fail at the time of the decision, as the Governing Council noted that that the purchase program would not necessarily be used in full if market conditions improve. With inflation fears easing, a better than expected initial jobless claims print, and the signing of the $1.9 trillion US dollars relief package into law by US President Biden may have sparked hopes that the US economy will continue to recover at a healthy pace without the risk of overheating, and that's why equities may have continued to trade north during the Asian session today as well. Remember that we've been repeatedly saying that inflation fears could ease soon, something that would help equities to rebound and trend north again. The latest market reaction confirms our view, which was based on the Fed's assessment that any spike in inflation in the months to come is likely to prove to be temporary. Yesterday, ECB President Lagarde was on the same page, noting that Eurozone inflation may pick up mostly due to transitory factors. Now, with the Fed noting that inflation in the US will rise and stay above 2% for some time in the years after 2023, we stick to our guns that the path of least resistance for equities may be to the upside. Other risk-linked assets like the Aussie and the Kiwi are likely to strengthen as well, while the US dollar is likely to continue to retreat. The safe havens yen and franc may also stay under selling interest. Now, as for today's events, during the early European morning, we got UK's monthly GDP for January, as well as the industrial and manufacturing production numbers for the same month. The monthly GDP rate fell to -2.9% month over month from 1.2%, while the industrial production and manufacturing production rates fell by more than expected. That said, the pound did not react, as weaker than expected prints were not actually a surprise if we take into account that the UK has been in full lockdown during the month of January. Thus, we will stick to our view that with the vaccinations proceeding very well in the UK and with Bank of England officials being aligned with the relaxed views of the Fed over the rally in bond yields around the globe, the pound may continue performing well. As for the rest of Friday's releases, Germany's final CPIs for February are forecast to confirm their preliminary estimates, while Eurozone's industrial production is anticipated to have rebounded 0.3% month over month in January, after contracting 1.6% in December. From Canada, we get the employment report for February. The unemployment rate is forecast to have ticked down to 9.3% from 9.4%, while the employment change is expected to show that the economy has gained 52.5 thousand jobs after losing 212.8 thousand in January. In the US, the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for March is coming out, and the forecast points to an increase to 78 from 76.8. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. At this point, I have to let you know that there will be no weekly Market Outlook webinar next Monday, but we will have the daily market review videos from Tuesday onwards. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.